In terms of things that are important in life, after the basics of food and water and shelter, art is in fact one of the most important things, because they are the means with which to study and understand the nature of being human and what it all entails. And it's the enrichment of the arts that people get from it that makes me want to be involved.
Not only do we have to keep our kids well fed, but we have to feed their souls in order for them to thrive. By bringing in the Visiting Artist Series in collaboration with Icicle Creek Center for the Arts, we give kids and their families an opportunity to see world-class performers with life-changing performances. It only takes one experience for someone where the light bulb goes on and it changes their life.
I asked my students, so why should people support the arts? One of them said they should support the arts because it encourages kids to try things they thought they couldn't do. So a little first grader raised his hand and said, yeah, like Mrs. Keene, after the blind pianist was here, he said, I went home and told my mom, Mom, I want to play piano. And he's taking piano lessons now.
To have something like Icicle Creek within a small community is phenomenal. For the art education piece especially, you know, these are kids that might not have opportunity to do that elsewhere. Teaching a kid that they can better themselves through music or through, you know, film. If they can find love at an early age for whatever they're doing, then they'll grow up and you know, contribute to society in their own way.
I don't know why you wouldn't want to support Icicle Creek Center for the Arts, just because every performance speaks to so many different people.
We have a world-class venue right down the street from us. You know, we're lucky enough that the foundation has been built for us, and it's our responsibility to make sure that we sustain that. So our kids can have this for their families.
We need to have the arts as part of our culture and life in this area, and we're very fortunate that we have ICCA, and we need to support it and build it and keep it viable.
Help to nourish the souls of our students in this community and support Icicle Creek Center for the Arts and the work that they do in our region, because it can't happen without you.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the fifth concert of the Icicle Creek Chamber Music Festival, the virtual edition of it. My name is Oksana Jokina, and I'm the artistic director of the program, as well as some other classical music programs at Icicle Creek Center for the Arts. In a moment, you're going to hear a really lovely introduction from one of the Institute alumni. As you know, in normal times, these 3 weeks in July, welcome a large number of students from all over the world who come and study with the faculty of the festival. We're not able to do that, but luckily we're able to bring them to virtually announcing the programs for the concerts and also just giving us a little glimpse of connectivity, even though some of them are very, very far away. So the greeting will come from Nadia Barrow from Australia, and I don't want to spoil it any further than that. But since Nadia recorded that greeting, Meta Weiss and I added a piece, and we didn't let her know. So I wanted to tell you that there will be two Mendelssohn pieces. We'll start with Song Without Words by Felix Mendelssohn for cello and piano, opus 109. And from there, we'll go to the Fantasy in G minor, the program that is listed. I'm sorry, the piece that is listed in the program. So just a little note on that, and of course, followed by the great Archduke Trio. I have been so very privileged to be a part of Icicle Creek for 20 years, mostly directing and developing this program. And we are so delighted and proud that we have brought this program from a regional program to a program with national and international presence, as you'll hear in a moment from Nadia, confirming that. And because of the great success of this program, I would really encourage you to donate and honor the success and the development and what we're able to do here at Icicle Creek Center for the Arts for our immediate community, for the national community, and for the global community. I thank you very much, and please enjoy the concert.
Hi, my name is Nadia Barra, and I am a cellist from Adelaide, Australia. I had the absolute joy and privilege of attending Icicle Creek Chamber Music Institute in 2018 and 19. At Icicle, I was mentored by the most incredible musicians from all around the world, and this year I'm very excited to watch and share Icicle Creek's virtual chamber concert series. The series includes 9 breathtaking concerts, and here I will provide you with the details of the 6th festival concert. The performance is taking place this Friday, the 24th of July at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, which for my fellow Australians is mid-morning this Saturday. We will be hearing Fanny Mendelssohn's Fantasy for Cello and Piano in G minor, which is somehow both heart-wrenching and uplifting as it transforms into this spinning dance-like spirit in the second half. And then we have Beethoven's Piano Trio in B flat major, opus 97, commonly referred to as Archduke Trio. The Archduke Trio is the last of Beethoven's piano trios and remains one of his best known chamber music works. I think it perfectly captures the essence of Icicle Creek, with the first movement emulating the mountains. They're so majestic with its grand sonata, and then it moves into this second movement that is playful and light scherzo, and a third movement which is singing and sorrowful and a little sad towards the end, but is quickly dispelled by a fourth movement that is dancing and light and playful. These works will be performed by violinist Murray Wang, cellists David Recruo and Maitre Weiss, and pianists Emily Phelps and Oksana Ezhikina.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.